Sai Ram to everybody. Thank you very much for your gracious presence this morning. I apologize to you for the inconvenience that we had to climb up the steps to reach the sixth floor, which is really a big ordeal, I know that. But it's beyond our control. But anyway, I'm so sorry. Well, this morning, while coming to this center, I had been to the college and they were showing video show of Bhagavan, video cassette. It was all about Swami speaking about his mother, father, his classmates. The foster mother happened to be Subbamma. She served the devotees to a great extent. In those days, she cooked for them. The whole reception and hospitality were taken care of by her. Swami had immense love for Subbamma. In other words, what Yashoda was during Krishna Avatara is Subbamma in such a Sai Avatara. What Devaki Devi in Krishna Avatara is Ishwaramma in such Sai Avatara. Action replayed, cassette rewind. So Swami had very intimate connection and love for this lady, Subbamma, the foster mother. Though I am independent, though I am renunciant, though I am away from all of you, Swami said, Subbamma, don't worry, I'll come and see you when the end approaches. I'll come and see you when the end approaches you. That was the promise given by Baba to Subbamma garu. At that time Swami was there at Madras. The end came and Swami was not here. And Subbamma garu left her body. And its rotten and dead body, it was full of ants all around, all ants. The body was stinking. People were about to lift the body to the cremation ground. It was at that time Baba comes there in his car with a beautiful smile. And then he said, what happened to Subbamma? What happened? She died, that's all. Swami, she is no more, they said. But Baba said, no, she has not died. And he came close to her body and asked everybody, remove the cloth covering her body. They removed the cloth and Swami said loudly, Subbamma, I am here. Then she opens her eyes. Then she recognizes Baba and says, oh Swami, you have come. You have come. And then Baba tells her, I am here because of the promise given to you. I said that I would come here when the end approaches. So I am here. I will never go back by the promise given to anybody. I will fulfill the promise. Then Swami said, get some glass of water and some tulsi leaves. And with the tulsi leaves, she made her sip few drops of water. And looking into the eyes of Swami, she said, I am very happy, Swami. And Swami said, yes, be happy. Yes, you may go now. Then she left the body. It is something like bidding farewell at the airport. Bye. Is not an occasion for crying or tragic moment. Here the departed soul, Subbamma says, bye Swami. And Swami says, nice. Yes, good. Yes. So parting is not always tragic. Parting is not like that. Sometimes it may be a bidding farewell, saying goodbye. Baba, what he spoke now, I'm watching that video and talking to you now. There at the college, they have shown that video. And Swami narrates the instance of his father, Venkamarazu. What happens is, one day Swami called devotees for an interview. They went into his interview, and Swami's father, Venkamarazu, comes from the village and stands at the interview room. Swami notices his presence. Yemi, Itluchinao, why have you come here? Yemi, why? What brought you here? No, Swami, I have come here to give you 500 rupees. Yemi, naaku 500 rupees. Why 500 rupees? Why? Then father tells him, look here, I am running some provisions shop here. I am supplying provisions to devotees, and this is my hard-earned money. Because of the lack of change, lack of small coins, I might have been indebted to some of those that visited my shop. So what I want you is, you distribute this money to everybody on that day. And here are 2 bags of rice and 2 bags of jaggery. Make some rice pudding and distribute to all poor people. Serve the food to everybody. Swami said, why are you telling all this? No, Swami, I know I am leaving. I want to tell you and go. Swami said, don't worry, nenu chusukuntanu, I'll take care of you. And father returns home, lies on the bed, Hari Om Tat Sat, interplanetary travel. That's what Swami says. The people will have his blessings while leaving the body. What more we want? What more we want? It was Adi Shankara who made a promise to his mother that he would visit her when the end approaches. Exactly, Adi Shankara visited her when she left her mortal coils. Avatar fulfilled the promise that way to Subbamma and father. Swami also narrates the way how his mother took leave of him. It was hot summer in Vrindavan, Whitefield, Bangalore. It is an annual feature to have summer courses on Indian culture and spirituality. And in those days, summer courses are held for students all over the India. So it's 1,000 students attended that summer courses. And Mother Eswaramma personally serves food to as many boys as possible. When anybody asks, Amma, why should you serve? There are volunteers to serve. Why do you serve food? She says, Swami is doing such nice things. Swami is conducting classes like this. And it is our good fortune to witness the whole program. So let me also participate in this activity. Like that, Eswaramma also served food to many, many boys. During that year, as the summer courses are going on in full swing, on 6th of May, what happened is this, to put in Swami's words. Swami is staying in the upstairs while Eswaramma is staying there in the downstairs. And it is a practice, I should say, in these parts, to chew pan. They chew pan. Swami also enjoys pan very much. It's nice to see him, how he makes pans all by himself. Very nice. Highly artistic. Wow, wow. He'll have a silver box by his side, and the betel leaves nicely cut, nicely piled up, and Swami, wow, takes it one after one. With those two little fingers. And he will not collect the whole lot and eat like most of us, like buffaloes. He won't eat like that. A very nice heart. One after one, one after one. Wow. So, it is the practice here in these parts. And Isharama also chews pan. And then, they don't take beetle nut straight away. They will just crush the beetle nut. Put it in a mortar, go on crushing it. And she does it personally. And then mix it, takes the pan. And that afternoon, after lunch, she is crushing the beetle nut, taka, 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 while Swami is staying there, upstairs. And suddenly, Isharama shouts, Swami, Swami, Swami. And Swami ka, ustuna, ustuna. And coming, I am coming. Swami came, but that time, Isharama was looking at his face, and Swami blessed her, made her sip some water, and she takes leave of Swami. Such a nice journey she left. And people thought that summer classes will be cancelled, that day would be a holiday. Swami said, why holiday? She left. Why holiday? I have sent her. No holiday. There will be regular classes today. And what happened? All people started speaking about Isharama. All classes. Those different topics are given. Every teacher started speaking about Isharama. That's what Baba said in the cassette which I just watched this morning along with students. Really, I felt so bad because I was translating his talk and I missed him very much. I also remember another instance in Vrindavan. His sister Venkamma fell sick and she was hospitalized in Manipal hospital. Swami had been to Manipal hospital to see how she was doing, and she died. And that dead body had to be brought to Puttaparthi. Swami gave instructions, let the body be taken to Puttaparthi for burial. On the same day, at 8:30, President of India visited Vrindavan. Swami gave a lecture, bhajans, prasadam distribution. And in the evening, there in Vrindavan, that's called a Trayi session, where Swami sits with boys and some special guests. He talks to them every day. It's very interesting. Swami's conversations with boys in Vrindavan, very interesting. He cuts jokes and all that. And then, Swami had his session, normal. I was walking along the lawns, slowly. I purposefully waited that I would get into the hall at the end. I allowed all boys to go in. I was just loitering on the lawns. Swami noticed me. Come here. Why are you loitering like that? Swami, I'm turning mad now. I'm not able to understand what's going on. What happened? Nothing had happened. No, Swami. I'm reminded of what you said long back. Atla, em cheppinanu? What did I say? In typical Rayalaseema style. Em cheppinanu? Em adatla? ఏమి చెప్పు. వాట్ డిడ్ ఐ సే? కమాన్ సార్. దెన్ ఐ సెడ్, స్వామి, ఇట్ ఈస్ టైమ్ ఆఫ్ లార్డ్ కృష్ణ. యూ సెడ్ దట్ డే కృష్ణ లెఫ్ట్ ద బాడీ, లార్డ్ కృష్ణ లెఫ్ట్ ద బాడీ. హీరింగ్ ద న్యూస్ కుంతీదేవి లెఫ్ట్ హర్ బాడీ, ద మదర్ ఆఫ్ 5 పాండవాస్. ఆన్ హీరింగ్ దట్ కృష్ణ ఈజ్ నో మోర్, షీ లెఫ్ట్ హర్ బాడీ. అండ్ ధర్మజ, ది ఎల్డెస్ట్ సన్ ఆఫ్ పంచ పాండవాస్, ఇన్స్ట్రక్టెడ్ ఫర్ ఎవ్రీథింగ్ టు బి డన్ టు ద బాడీ ఆఫ్ కుంతి, ద మదర్. ది హీ వాజ్ ఆల్ ది పాండవాస్ ఆర్ క్రయింగ్ ఫర్ ద లాస్ ఆఫ్ కృష్ణ. దెన్ అట్ ద సేమ్ టైమ్ ద కరోనేటెడ్ ఎ లిటిల్ బాయ్ యాజ్ ద కింగ్, పరీక్షిత్, వెరీ లిటిల్ బాయ్ ఈజ్ కరోనేటెడ్ యాజ్ ద కింగ్. ఆల్ ది త్రీ టేకింగ్ ప్లేస్, క్రయింగ్ ఫర్ లాస్ ఆఫ్ కృష్ణ, టూ మేకింగ్ అరేంజ్మెంట్స్ ఫర్ ద క్రిమేషన్ ఆఫ్ మదర్ కుంతి, థర్డ్ కరోనేషన్ ఆఫ్ ఎ బాయ్ యాజ్ ద కింగ్. ఆల్ ది థింగ్స్ వెంట ఆన్ స్వామి, దట్స్ వాట్ యూ సెడ్. అవును చెప్పినాను. అయితే ఏమైంది? ఎస్ ఐ సెడ్, సో వాట్, దట్స్ వాట్ యు హావ్ డన్ నౌ స్వామి అని. నేనేం చేసినాను? వాట్ హ్యావ్ ఐ డన్? ఐ హావ్ కమ్ టు నో దట్ దిస్ మార్నింగ్ వెంకమ్మ గారు లెఫ్ట్. ఐ ఆల్సో హ్యావ్ సీన్ యూ టాకింగ్ రిసీవింగ్ ది ప్రెసిడెంట్ ఆఫ్ ఇండియా, అండ్ ఐ ఆల్సో హ్యావ్ సీన్ యూ అటెండింగ్ భజన్స్, నౌ టాకింగ్ టు బాయ్స్. హౌ ఈజ్ ఇట్ పాసిబుల్ స్వామి, ఆల్ దీస్ థింగ్స్ టేకింగ్ ప్లేస్? దెన్ బాబా సెడ్, చూడు బంగారు, నేను ఏది చేస్తానో అదే చెప్తాను. వాట్ ఐ డూ ఐ సే, వాట్ ఐ డూ నాట్ డూ ఐ డోంట్ సే దట్, ఐ సే దట్ వాట్ ఐ డూ. ఏమి, కృష్ణావతారం చేసినాను, ఇప్పుడు చేస్తున్నా ఉన్నాను, ఏమి కొత్త ఏముందప్ప, చేసేదే చేస్తా ఉన్నాను. వాట్ ఈజ్ న్యూ అబౌట్ ఇట్? వాట్ ఐఎమ్ డూయింగ్ ఐఎమ్ టెల్లింగ్, దట్స్ ఆల్. దట్ ఈస్ భగవాన్ శ్రీ సత్యసాయి బాబా, హూ ఈజ్ నాట్ రఫుల్డ్, హూ ఈజ్ నాట్ డిస్టర్బ్డ్ బై ఎనీ ఇన్సిడెంట్, బై ఎనీథింగ్ వాట్ ఎవర్ మే బి. అదర్ సిస్టర్ పార్వతి, పార్వతమ్మ గారు, ది అండర్ సిస్టర్, షీ పాస్డ్ అవే, అండ్ ఐ వాజ్ కమింగ్ ఫ్రమ్ బృందావన్. వైల్ రీచింగ్ దిస్ ప్లేస్ బై బస్, ఐ సా ద బాడీ బీయింగ్ టేకెన్ ఇన్ ఎ ప్రొసెషన్, అండ్ దట్ ఈవినింగ్ స్వామి కాల్ ఫర్ అన్ ఇంటర్వ్యూ. వాట్ షల్ ఐ డూ? షల్ ఐ బిహేవ్ యాజ్ ఇఫ్ ఐ డూ నాట్ నో? షల్ ఐ సే ఐఎమ్ సారీ స్వామి, కండోలెన్సెస్ టు యూ ఫర్ ద సాడ్ డిమైజ్? యు సే షట్ అప్, గెట్ అవుట్. వాట్ షల్ ఐ డూ? ఆర్ కెన్ ఐ సే ఐ డూ నాట్ నో ఎనీథింగ్? యూ కెనాట్ సే దట్. దెన్ ఐ సెడ్, స్వామి, ఐ సా మెనీ పీపుల్ క్రయింగ్. ఏమి ఏడుస్తూ ఉంటారు దేనికి? వై ఆర్ పీపుల్ క్రయింగ్? స్వామి, పార్వతమ్మ గారు, నోన్ టు మెనీ పీపుల్ షీ డైడ్, అండ్ ఆల్ దోస్ పీపుల్ దట్ నో హర్ ఆర్ క్రయింగ్ ఫర్ హర్ డిమైజ్. దట్స్ హౌ ఐ పుట్ ఇట్. దెన్ బాబా సెడ్, ప్లీజ్ అండర్స్టాండ్ దిస్. ఏమప్పా, నాకు అదంతా లేదు, ఐఎమ్ నాట్ ఎట్ ఆల్ అటాచ్డ్. సరిపోతారు, దే ఆర్ బాన్ అండ్ దే డై, దే నథింగ్ టు వరీ అబౌట్ ఇట్. నాకు అదంతా ఏముండదప్పా, అదేమి పెట్టుకోకు. యూ టూ డోంట్ హ్యావ్ సచ్ ఫీలింగ్స్. ఐ డోంట్ హ్యావ్ ఎనీథింగ్ టు డూ, దట్స్ వాట్ బాబా సెడ్. అండ్ సమ్ టైమ్ ఫ్యూ కపుల్ ఆఫ్ ఇయర్స్ గో లాంగ్ బ్యాక్, ది బ్రదర్ ఇన్ లా పాస్డ్ అవే. ద బ్రదర్ ఇన్ లా ఈజ్ హిస్ మెటర్నల్ అంకుల్ ఓన్లీ, హీ పాస్డ్ అవే. అండ్ కస్తూరి, రైటర్ అండ్ స్పీకర్, ద బయోగ్రఫర్ ఆఫ్ స్వామి, ది లైక్ ఆఫ్ హూమ్ వీ డోంట్ కమ్ అక్రాస్, దట్ ఈస్ ఫర్ షూర్. అండ్ కస్తూరి వెంట్ క్లోజ్ టు స్వామి, అండ్ స్వామి, ఐ నో యూ, అండ్ వీ హ్యావ్ సీన్ దట్ జెంటిల్మన్, యువర్ బ్రదర్ ఇన్ లా, హీ పాస్డ్ అవే, అండ్ వీ మీట్ ఎవ్రీ డే, వీ ఫీల్ సో బ్యాడ్ అబౌట్ ఇట్. ప్లీజ్ నోట్ దిస్ పాయింట్, వాట్ బాబా సెడ్. ఏమి కస్తూరి ఏడుస్తూ ఉన్నారు, ఏమంటారా, వై డు యూ క్రై? రైళ్ళు వస్తూ ఉంటాయి, పోతూ ఉంటాయి, స్టేషన్ మ్యాష్ ఏడుస్తాడా? దేర్ ఇస్ రైల్వే ప్లాట్ఫామ్, ట్రైన్స్ అరైవల్, డిపార్చర్, స్టేషన్ మాస్టర్ విల్ నాట్ క్రై. Trains arrive, so what? And trains depart, then what? Yeah, stage master pane undali. What work that the station master has? Yeah, vastu untaru, vastu untaru. They come and go. And if the trains don't come and go, station master will be unemployed. I am station master, pa, vastu untaru, vastu untaru pane undali. They come and go. These are things that I am recalling when I saw the video this morning, which I wanted to share with you. I was thinking as to what I should talk to you. Baba's detachment is really amazing. Say, for example, birthday, grand celebration, very grand celebration, international conference, feeding the poor or feeding the devotees for 10 days, food supply, everything, so many programs. On 24th, next day after birthday, normal. Swami, chala baga ja aayna. Swami, everything went off well, aayna, chala, that's all. He doesn't say, you know what happened yesterday, you know what, as we do that. We do that. But Swami finished Hari Om Tatsat. It's a full stop, it's not comma. He's not at all bothered. Manchi, good. Any function. Supposing he leaves Puttaparthi to Bangalore. No talk about Puttaparthi at all. He's completely Bangalore man. Talking to Bangalore people only. Even if I go from here, I'm not related to you. You are nobody to me, that's all. The lesson is not that he doesn't identify you, not that he doesn't know me or you either. Living in the present, living in the moment, not yesterday or tomorrow, not the past or the future. Living this moment is the message of Bhagavan Sri Sat Sai Baba. Once we ask Swami, why are you so happy? Why? Then Swami laughed. Are there will somebody to ask why are you unhappy? You are the only fellow to ask why I am happy. What question is it? I'm always happy. How, Swami? Then he said, I'm always happy because I don't think of brood over the past. I am not worried of the future. I am not worried of the future. I don't brood over the past. I live in the present. Therefore, I am happy. Jarugunnu jarakamanadu. Kalunnadi kakamanadu. Jarugutta untadi, pota untadi. Manaku adem undadappa annadu. What is destined to happen? It will happen. Why should you worry? Therefore, I met one lady yesterday. She went on crying, Swami, no more, I said, stop it. 1 year over. What should we do now? Not crying. We may cry, but yet, not continuously. We may have to live as deserving devotees of Bhagavan, Sri Sat Sai Baba. Till now, everybody started quoting Baba, my life is my message. Baba said, my life is my message. Today, our life should be his message. People will look at us, how lovely he is, how affectionate he is, how friendly he is, how blissful he is. If I look at him, I feel as if I am talking to Baba. That's how each and every one of us should be. Everyone should be a mini Baba, a mini Sathya Sai Baba, a person embodying, personifying all his beautiful, wonderful, divine qualities. Then that is the way of paying tribute expressing our gratitude to Bhagavan, not simply crying. It appears as though, as I have nothing else to do, let me cry now. It won't help you. It won't help you. We should get out of it. We should live to his message. We should spread his message, which is very important. I was just looking at the biography of Mr. Tigrade. Tigrade, who was here for a long time. Oh, hefty personality. Three of us would come to his size. Very tall and well-built man. Very silent man. Highly meditative. Totally spiritual. Very nice to know him and see him. Swami did not talk to him for 15 years. 15. He did not look at me for 7 years. I thought that I am quite senior. But I am just half to half of what Tigrade is. But there is wide gulf of difference. What he says is this. During that period, when Swami did not talk to me for 15 years, he says, I never had any desire to have an interview. I never wanted any interview. I never wanted him to come close to him. I never wanted to touch his feet. I developed love for his literature. I developed inquisitiveness, curiosity to know his teachings. I started reading. I started speaking about him. I started spreading his message. That was so intense. And then he says, during that 15-year period of utter neglect from the side of Baba, Tigrade says that his interest in business slowed down. Interest in business is gone. It is very difficult to lose interest in business. Business is so infectious, so contaminating, so bothering. It will not leave you. But here is a man with a chain of hotels. Rock hotels, rock music hotels, all over the world. He says during that period of exile, 15 years, he lost interest in business. He developed interest in his message. Further, he said he desired to contemplate, to meditate on nameless, formless God. Nameless, formless God, without a beginning, nor an end. He says, 15-year-long period is a period of penance. It is a period of intensive sadhana for me. That's what he said. Therefore, my friends, we should also take this in the same spirit. When Swami is not in our midst in the physical form, Swami, let me feel your energy. Let me feel your blessing. Let me have your experiences. Let me be full of your message. That should be the attitude that we should develop. The 1 year completion after he left the body is coming to a close. The 24th of April, Samadhi Day. The body is limited to anybody. Out of the body, you are unlimited. Within the body, you are limited. Out of the body, you are unlimited. Within the body, you are conditioned. Out of the body, you are unconditioned. Within the body, you are related. your relationships. Out of the body, you are related to everybody. Relationship with everybody. Within the body, you are bound by time and space. Out of the body, you are beyond time and space. Within the individual, within the body, you are an individual. Out of the body, you are universal. Today, Baba is universal. He is not individual. And today, Baba is cosmic. Today, Baba is energy. Today, is Baba is omnipresent, omnipotent, and omniscient. And today, He makes us feel Him every moment more than before. Earlier, there were darshan times. Earlier, there was bhajan times. Earlier, we had our own schedules. And today, Baba is available all the time. When He is in Ajur Mandir, He is available when He comes out. When He left the body, He is available within you. He is available to you all the time, to everyone, everywhere. That is the spirit with which we have to take it, take the event. Therefore, my friends, we should go on spreading this to our friends that Baba is ever present. Somebody, if anyone says Baba left, our answer should be, the one that comes and goes is human. The one who never comes and never goes, the one who is eternal, immortal, ever existent, ever vibrant, totally radiant. That consciousness is divinity. So never say Baba left. No. We may leave, but He doesn't leave. He's telling in the talk. Remember this. You may leave me, I will not leave you. You may like to leave me, I cannot live without you. That's what Baba said. I cannot live without you. Such an association, such a bondage, universal love that Baba developed. That should come to our daily experience. That should come to our thought repeatedly so that we don't miss Him, nor His physical body. Baba said, for all this, what should we do? Because some people would like to always live in the past, particularly people of my age group. We always say that when I joined service, so what? You joined long ago. Well, so what? You know what a problem I had. Why do you add problem to me now? I know many people, so what? So, we people of our generation, the geriatric, want to go back in memory, always, and go on speaking about it. Let's stop that. And then also, yesterday someone was telling me, why should I live? Why should I continue to live? Swami should have sent me before He left. I said, what is this nonsense? He has not left. You don't leave. Nobody leaves. No. Nobody has come. Nobody can go. It is the body, after all, body comes and goes. Why body? You don't go. This is the Sanatana Dharma. That's why people say He left. He left what? Left the body. But He is here. So, it's continuous, eternal. The one of continuity to eternity is life. The body is born and goes, that's all. That is the quintessence of Vedanta. That is the essence of spirituality. All the 85 years he has been speaking about it. He never addresses the gathering as ladies and gentlemen. He will never say that. He never says, ladies and gentlemen, how do you say that? There may be many people who are not gentlemen. So we cannot take it for granted, gentlemen. Ungentlemanly fellows, percentage is more also. So he doesn't prefer to say, ladies and gentlemen. And he doesn't say, brothers and sisters. Why? There's no love. There's no love. The brothers fight with each other, sisters fight with each other, saying, this is my seat, this is my seat, that's your seat, this is my group, that's your group. You can't be brothers, sisters. It's more political stunt. To say brother and sisters is a political stunt. We are not brothers and sisters. So Swami says, embodiments of love, embodiments of the divine Atma, from the point to the spirit, from the point of consciousness, we are one and the same. That is encased within the body. Therefore, we should always think of those things that Baba said. All these limitations are because of the mind, that's all. When the mind is individualized, the problem comes. When one the mind is universal, this problem does not come. When one person is in pain, when you also feel the pain, yes, you are universal. When one is suffering, when you also suffer, you are universal. So, we are not universal. We are totally individual. This individuality, universality, is the duality of the mentality. It is only the mind that brings in all these things. Therefore, 3 points they said. First point, know the mind. Know the mind. What? Yes. Know the mind? Yes. I know, you do not know. The pity of it is, you do not know that you do not know. First, to know that you do not know. Then you can know something. Therefore, know the mind. Know the mind meaning, this limitation, unlimitedness, individual, universal, duality, pain, gain, pleasure, profit, loss, victory, defeat, all this nonsense is because of the mind. So know the mind. And the mind that is the cause for birth and rebirth. So know the mind. Okay, after knowing, what should I do? Transform the mind. Transform the mind. How to transform? You can transform the mind by knowing what it is. Simple example. Baba gives this example. It's in some wedding is taking place. Wedding. Bride's party, bridegroom party, busy making arrangements. One fellow from the street came inside. Tip-top dressed and all. He went to bride's father. Are the arrangements ready? Have you sent breakfast to the bridegroom party? Are they well accommodated? Are they well looked after? The bride's party thought there's a VIP from the bridegroom party. Then he goes to bridegroom and then tells, hurry up, it's time for the wedding, how long you take? Please move to the place. The priest is calling you. Dress up, come on, go. Then they thought he's VIP from the bride's side. Bride party thought he's a VIP from groom's party. the bridegroom party thought, is very important man from the bride's party. So both of them started respecting him. So marriage took place. At the end, they were talking, who is this fellow? Sir, how is he related? They said, how is he related? He is not related to anybody. He just came there for the sumptuous food. That's all. If possible, take some saris and gold. That's all. He was pretending as if he is related to them. He is not at all related. When both the parties came and started inquiring, who is this fellow? He understood what's going to happen. He nicely slipped from there, ran away. When once he came to understand that people are trying to identify him, trying to recognize him, he disappeared. He left. Similarly, mind is like that. When once I know my mind, when once I watch my mind, when once I am a witness to my thought, the mind gets transformed. Know the mind, first step. Second, transform the mind. The transformation of the mind is possible by the awareness of the mind. We all know that none of us are the mind. You are not the mind. I am not the mind. Why? Suddenly we say, I am not in good moods. Oh, I see. My mind is not proper. My mind is disturbed. My mind is agitated. My mind is angry. So you know your mind. You know your thought. I don't know your mind. I don't know your thought. But you know your mind. You know your thought. When once you know your mind, when once you are conscious, aware of the thought, the mind gets transformed. So, when know the mind, first step takes you to the transformation of the mind, the second step, which is quite automatic. When mind gets transformed, what happens? It will just as that fellow ran away, that fellow slipped, the mind also will slip. Oh, I am detected. My bad thoughts are watched. My good thoughts are watched. My planning, my maneuvering, my manipulation, they are watched. Then mind will run away. That is called liberation of the mind. So, knowledge of the mind takes to the transformation of the mind and ultimately to the liberation of the mind. So, liberation is not a state. Liberation is not an achievement. Liberation is heaven and there is not an attainment. No, 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 no. It is only unawareness, unconsciousness of the nature of the mind. With a simple example, there is a curtain. Behind the curtain are actors. To see the actors and to see the drama start, what would happen? The curtain should raise. Similarly, to know the reality, to know the divinity, the curtain of the mind should drop. The moment curtain of the mind drops, yes, divinity is ready. The drama commences. The divinity is ready for all of us that comes to our experience. So there is no bondage. People think, well, I am in bondage, the life is a bondage. No, nonsense. It's all your thinking. Bondage is your thinking. There is no bondage at all. Some people think that a family is a bondage. friends are bondage, love is bondage, chichi nonsense. Love is not bondage. Friendships, relationships are not a bondage. What is bondage? I-ness is bondage. I-ness is bondage. This is mine. I am doing. I am that. That is bondage. This sort of I-ness is bondage. When one that I-ness is gone, you may have properties, you may have family, you have all the love, everything free, which is not at all a bondage. And this I-ness is the mind. This I-ness is the ego. This I-ness is illusion. This I-ness is delusion. This I-ness is a passing cloud. This I-ness is unawareness. This I-ness is unconsciousness. This I-ness is Maya. See, for a disturbing thing, it has got so many titles. Whereas divinity has only one title. That's all. Whereas I-ness has so many titles, ego, mind, momentary, the world, and all that. Therefore, the way is to know the mind, transform the mind, and liberate the mind. When once the mind gets liberated, I am not touched by emotions, I am not touched by feelings, I am not carried away by the dual world, I am steadily established in the reality. You are clearly established in the reality, that what Bhagavan says. Really speaking, it's very interesting. It's very interesting to note one point what Baba says. We think the one who can quote freely from Bible, Quran, Bhagavad Gita is a scholar. Yes, he is a scholar, but not a man of wisdom. Scholarship is not spirituality. Scholarship is knowledge. Scholarship is acquired by learning. By learning, you get the knowledge. Because of the knowledge, you have scholarship. Because of scholarship, you are a scholar, but not a spiritual man. I may look funny. I may look crazy. I may look as if what I speak is nonsense, but it is true. If scholarship, if memory, if recapitulation, if recalling, if I can repeat, I am only a DVD record player. A DVD record player, come on! DVD record player is a great scholar, but not spiritual. But not spiritual. Veda chanting, come on, do it. Tape recorder can do it. Quoting scriptures, go to Google. Computers, Google. Any bloody topic you type, whole thing will come about it. Any topic. Therefore, to the modern society, who is your God? Google.com. Google.com is my God. Why? Google knows all things. Nonsense. Therefore, my friends, learning is not awareness. Knowledge is not awareness. Reading is not awareness. Memory is not awareness. Oh, then what is awareness? Knowing. Please, I'm not a lecturer in English, I'm just a biologist. So don't mistake me for English literature. No, I'm just a student of biology. See, knowing is a beautiful word. That is important. If I say, I know, past, finished. Supposing I say, sir, he is so and so, I know, so I don't have to tell you, better you go. So if you say, I know, means you have already known, I don't have to tell you. If you say, well, I will know. So I have to wait until you are prepared to know. When you say, I will know, means I have to wait until you are prepared to know. If you say, I know, you know already. So I know, I will know, useless in spirituality. So you cannot say, I know. No, no, no. Because you know a dead thing, you know a past thing, but God is present. How do you say, I know? God is present, God is not past. So to say, I know about Sat Sai Baba, is a fool, number one. Because Sai Baba, now you cannot say, I know him, I met. Better you write some biography, some history, not that. So, I will know him. Okay, please wait until next life. So, knowing is very important. Knowing is spiritual. Knowledge is not spiritual. Futuristic temperament, futuristic attitude is not spiritual. Present is spiritual. What is present? Knowing. So, I am knowing. Knowing meaning present, continuous. Knowing is present, continuous. If I say, I am knowing my scripture. Meaning, you are in eternal search. That's what Baba says. Constant Integrated Awareness. CIA. Constant Integrated Awareness is present, continuous process, knowing. Therefore, the liberation, the heaven, the nirvana, moksha, lies in knowing. Therefore, knowing the mind, knowing the divine, knowing the divinity is something that brings us closer and closer to divinity and establish ourselves in that divinity itself. One example, you know, some of the people, they bring parrots. The parrots will say, Ram, 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 Sai Ram, 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 say Ram, Ram. People are happy. And that fellow will carry the parrot. Hey, come on, speak. Ram, Ram. Ah, see, my parrot speaks. A wise man saw that. And what is it? Sir, my parrot speaks. Let him speak. Ram, Ram, Ram. Your parrot is speaking like a pundit. Pundit also speaks. Parrot is also speaking. Parrot talk is the talk of a pundit. The parrot does not know that it is saying Rama, Rama, Rama. It was I'm trained like that. Pundit also repeats slokas. Parrot talk. Therefore, spirituality is knowing, seeing. Knowing and seeing, not merely learning, no, not merely knowledge, that's what it is. On the other hand, as I said, only thing is, I can know how to know. I know how to know. What do you mean? I want to know about a plant. Well, better I pick up a plant and study. If I want to know about something, I can pick up a book and study. If I want to see, if I want to know, I can go and see. But what is knowing? For knowing, you don't have to go. You don't have to see. Knowing meaning, drop the I-ness. drop the I-ness, the ego, then starts the process of knowing. The process to know is the mind. The process of knowing is possible by dropping the mind. That is the difference. Dropping the mind is knowing. Through the mind is to know. Through the mind is to acquire knowledge. That's what it is, the reality what it is. Instead of that, what our people do is, instead of treating the mind, knowing the mind, what they do is, I fast on Thursday night. I fast, I don't eat, Thursday night I'm spiritual. If you fast, so what happened? Next morning you can eat more. You'll be more hungry. So instead of regular 2 idlis, you'll have 6 idlis. That's all. So by fasting, by some people, you know, they don't shave. Abu, they have the long hair and the clothes dirty and spiritual life. Horrible life is not spiritual. It is not a spiritual life. It is a terrible, horrible, condemned life. Ugliness is not spirituality. Cleanliness is next to godliness. Not ugliness is godliness. No ugly fellow would say that. Therefore, one should be clean. One should be neat. One should be healthy. One should be handsome. One should be presentable. As beautiful as possible. Because body, you have not made it in the laboratory. Body is God's gift. A precious jewel. Nothing is more precious than the body. Supposing I'll tell you, I'll give you diamond. Are you prepared to drop your body? I'll give you a diamond. Are you ready to drop your body? You will say, I can get the diamond if you drop the body first. I don't have to drop the body. To get the diamond, you drop it, then I'll get it. So my point, the whole world is not worth it. If I am to die now. The whole world, supposing I give you, I'll give the whole world. Are you ready to die? I don't want the world. I live in my own world. Therefore, this has to be taken care of. To condemn the body, to torture the body, to fast the body, illness. Illness is sickness. Wellness is divinity. If you are well, you are godly. If you are ill, you are sickly. Therefore, those that do not preserve their body, those that do not maintain their body in the name of religion are perverts. They are all perverts. You see Baba how clean he is. Perfect. See, you don't see him grow nails. No. Nails very, very clean. And see his dress. Fold perfect. The fold should be like that. First class. That is the style of Baba. His dress, his gestures, eating style, walking style, perfect. Perfect. Religion or spirituality does not mean dragging your legs like a buffalo or ugly looks like a pig or a chick. That's not religion. We should be very fine, slim and trim, quite fit enough, because body is the temple of God. Body is the temple of God. The temple has got to be clean. I visited some of the temples abroad. I visited some of the churches abroad. I visited some Buddha temples in Thailand and Japan. How clean they are, really. Wow, wow, very clean. Though thousands of people come there, thousands of devotees come there, the place is very, very clean. Similarly, when the body is the temple of God, it has got to be very clean, neat, the temple. Torturing the body is not the way to religion. Then I can tell you the thing is this, a thought for you as you return home after this satsang. Please reflect on this idea, something to think about it. A seed is sown. Seed that is sown grows into a tree, is it not? Where is the tree? Where is the tree? Inside the seed. It is the seed that grows into the tree. Am I not right? So, tree is hidden in the seed. Am I not right? Good. How does the tree come out of the seed? Can the seed be like that and tree come out? No. The seed should break. The seed should crack. The seed should burst. When the seed loses its form, when the seed dies, when the seed disappears, the tree grows. Is it not our common experience? When the tree is there, seed is lost. The whole tree is contained within the seed. Only when the seed loses its name and form, the tree grows, it sprouts, it germinates. Likewise, everyone here, all of us, is a potential seed. You are a potential seed. I am a potential seed with the tree of divinity within us. The tree of divinity is within the seed of life. Your life is a seed. My life is a seed. In this life is the tree of divinity hidden within. When this tree of divinity is to come out, is to germinate, is to sprout, is to blossom, is to fruit, what is to happen? Seed should break. Seed should die. So similarly, my I-ness. Oh, good. So, instead of the seed breaking, my watch wants to break. Good, why not? Thank you. So, the seed should break. So, this I-ness should break. This identification, this separateness, this isolation, this speciality, this individuality should break, should disappear, for the tree of divinity to blossom. So that which is potential is to become actual. Potential has to turn into actuality. Potential has to turn into actuality. Or if the seed remains a seed, it is materiality. So material is to remain as a seed. Spiritual is to germinate into a tree by losing its own separateness, its own identification. That is quite possible. You know, here is a flame, candle, flame. The flame wants to rise up. The flame will never go down. The flames, yajna, the flames will rise up. Similarly, the fire of divinity within us, the fire of divinity, the flame of reality will try to come up, will try to get out of this body, name, mind, reputation, status, dignity, social norms. It wants to get out. Let the flames burn, fly high. That is the true reality. Therefore, my friends, this morning, let us know our potential. In Bangalore also, you must have noticed, not only Bangalore, everywhere. In summer, It is dry in summer. Suddenly when there are some rains in May, you find green lawns growing. In summer, neatly shaven, as in Tirumala Tirupati shaven head, neatly gone. When the rains in toward the end of the May, you find grass growing. Where are the seeds? Where are the seeds? Who has sown the seeds? The seeds are already there. The seeds are already there in the soil, waiting to germinate, just as you wait for the next flight. Next flight, you have to change there, Frankfurt. So you wait, get to the next flight to go to New York. Likewise, waiting. So the seed is waiting to germinate. It is within the soil. Outside you don't see it. When it grows, you find the lawns. Similarly, the seed of divinity is within us. It is waiting. The moment there is a rain of igniting the flame, the moment there is rain of spiritual practice, the moment there is rain of introspection, the moment there is rain of meditation, the seed germinates. The seed grows. That is realization. Realization is nothing but the hidden potential becoming actual. The seed hidden sprouting up with the rain. So, this moment we should try to receive the rain. We don't have to try also. When there's rain, the seed germinates automatic. So don't say, I do that, I do that. Please don't do. Because if you do anything, it is the mind that does. Rule is this. What is the rule? Anything that is reachable, anything that is achievable, anything that is attainable through the body and the mind is worldly, totally worldly. Sir, I do the, come on, you do it, but it's not spiritual. I make a beautiful statue. I just worship every day. Statue is made by you. Who is great? You are the statue. You made a painting. Who is greater than the other? Your painting or you? So if you question like that, you'll certainly understand. Anything the product of the body, anything expression of the mind is worldly, totally materialistic. When once it is beyond, it is spiritual. May this spiritual path be the guideline in the years to come. May Bhagavan be with you forever and evermore and bless you. I apologize to you once again for the trouble you have taken in climbing the steps all over because of the power failure. Thank you very much for being here. Thank you, Sai Ram. Om Asato Ma Sadgamaya Tamaso Ma Jyotirgamaya Mrutyormaha Amrutangamaya Om Samastaloka Sukhino Bhavantu Samastaloka Sukhino Bhavantu Samasta Loka Sukhino Bhavantu Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. जय बोलो भगवान श्री सच्चाई बाबा जी की। प्लीज रिसीव प्रसादम।